So this time we're gonna motorize the lunar rover using the micro motors. The idea is to put the micro motors between the suspension arm and using the planetary gear hub to gear them down. Now, in order to do that, I already made a small prototype here. And there are a few details I would like to mention. I had to cheat a bit. First of all, one shock absorber was replaced with two shock absorbers at the side, so there is space in between them for the motors. And one thing I also had to improvise and modify or cheat or whatever. Instead of using the original CV joint for the hub, I'm using this toggle joint here. And because it allows me to put the motor one stud deeper inside, and that is required because there is gonna be stuff coming here and probably here in the back, and I will need space here, and this is the only way I managed to find to basically drive the planetary gear hub. And it works quite well. As long as the angle is not too high, it works without problems, so I'm really happy with the solution I managed to find. Another thing that I will also do is motorize the steering. For the steering, I'm this time using a part up L motor, which is gonna be placed like this between the seats, and it's gonna be geared down and it's gonna be steering the arms here. And on top of it all, there will be a BuWizz 3.0, which will be placed right here where the handle and this cover are. So it's gonna be placed like here, and it'll be able to move so that you can still unfold the seats and fold the whole thing together. So this is the basic idea, and let's see how it goes. Okay, so here is the finished rover, and everything just like barely fits on the table. Let's take it apart, unfold it. So first we're gonna do these two. Okay, and now this. So the rover is fitted. We have four-wheel drive, four-wheel steering, and I'm using electronic differential. So when I'm steering in one direction, the motors on the inner side slow down and the motors on the other side accelerate. There's also enough torque to basically spin all wheels. It's not a race machine, but I think it's quite fast, and well, let's just say I'm really happy how it turned out. I have to say that this is actually one of my most complicated modifications I ever did, because unlike a usual vehicle, this thing has to fold. And I was really limited with space here and here. And I am really, really happy how it turned out. I think this is one of the most, I don't know, the best modifications we did recently. And if you like it too, then stay tuned and see how it works outside.